As you know, there's phase one and two clinical studies on Alzheimer's disease, where they were given 500 milligrams or 1,000 milligrams of resveratrol a day. And both of these studies found that there was a reduction in amyloid-beta 42 in cerebral spinal fluid. There was an improvement in cognitive function and a couple of other parameters. So it was kind of interesting because I recently had Dr. Dale Bredesen on the podcast, and he has this whole protocol where he's able to, with certain, diet and lifestyle factors, improve cognitive function, and also by MRI, shown to reverse some of the atrophy in the hippocampus. And so resveratrol was on his, he's got this long list, and I kind of like everything in the kitchen sink where I was like, geez, what is all, and resveratrol was on there. I never really knew why until I very recently was reading a little bit of the clinical studies. I thought that was super interesting as well. And then the other thing that was interesting, as you know, is the autophagy, because resveratrol seems to be activating autophagy. And I also interviewed Guido Cromer on the podcast.
Well, you did.
And he talks about these three signals that are important for autophagy. And one of them is the decrease in protein acetylation. Yeah, because sirtuins are histone deacetylases. So that would lead to, right, a decrease in protein
That's
acetylation.
exactly right. So that's how these Pac-Man enzymes are working. And one of the enzymes that they work on is an autophagy protein that goes and destroys bad protein. So it's perfectly reasonable to think that if you take resveratrol, it might be clearing the body of those proteins.
I have seen a study with resveratrol. So that's
Yeah, Richard Turner, I believe, that's the study I think you're
Richard
referring
Turner,
to, and it looked
probably.
really promising. And he did what looked like a very convincing study, but he actually is still trying to raise the money to do his larger trial. And I'm trying to help him with that. But I would love to see that repeated and done in more people.
I know that Dr. Cromer has published a study looking at biomarkers of autophagy in humans after they've been fasted, and I think one of those was looking at lice, the acetylation on lysine or something. It seemed to seem working. So it's all very interesting.
The NAD boosters also help the brain. So at least in mice, a couple of labs have published now in top journals like Cell that raising the NAD levels in the brain also improves memory and slows down the advancement of Alzheimer's. In mice, admittedly, I know we've cured Alzheimer's in mice
Well,
thousands of
both
times.
nicotinamide riboside and nicotinamide mononucleotide have been shown to do that in animal studies, right?
Yeah, you've been. Yeah, I'm amazed how much you know. So that's true. I would love to do a human study. Actually, one of the benefits that we might see is also improved blood flow. And that might be helpful for vascular dementia because, as I'm sure you know, we've shown that NMN and others have shown for NR that it also helps with blood flow and actually mimic exercise and regrow the vascular system. And we've done that for muscle. We've got some early results that it also helped restore blood flow in the brain, which is badly needed for a lot of elderly people.
Yeah, no, that's a big, I mean, that's a big thing for cognitive function. And so NMN was able to do that
In the mice,
in
yeah.
mice.